같은 말이 또 다른
의미로
다른 의미로 계속 뒤바뀌는 그런 그 상태를 이제 얘기하는 것 같고
Thank you.
He needs proof, but at the same time, he confuses you.
We've had the painting in the lab for about almost a year now.
Yeah.
And we look at it every day, and every day we always say we find something new.
It's so true.
Our goals were very simple, I would say, in the beginning. But then I think as we kept looking more and more into it, you know, more than meets the eye.
It didn't just start off as a red painting, or it wasn't initially conceived as a red painting.
You start thinking about what's underneath the red.
In the background, if you look closely, you can see little glimpses of blue peeking through.
The floor has glimpses of pink. There are glimpses of ochre.
He leaves those colors at the edges of the furniture.
And we see little clues like that throughout the painting.
When we unframed the painting, we saw very clearly on the edges there were these colors present. That was one of our first discoveries that really intrigued us.
That's amazing. Because there is another way up here. It covers the whole, where it stops, covers the whole back.
It confirmed that this blue that we see on the edge extends possibly throughout the entirety of the wall. The pink extends throughout the entirety of the foreground, and then the furniture itself was painted with an ochre yellow.
And then you see drips. Drips of pink, drips of blue. And they said, oh, so this is the same blue that I'm seeing in this little area.
We decided to take a microscopic sample of paint from the edge, and we mounted them to be able to look at them under the microscope and see the stratigraphy.
With those cross-sections, we also understood clearly how the layers were very defined. We knew then that the red was applied when those bottom layers were dry.
We acquired a new instrument called an XRF scanner. What that does is able to map elements across a surface. We didn't really expect there to be any super new findings, but in scanning the wall, we found vertical lines that go all the way down from the top to the floor. And those were in chromium, which indicates that they were probably done in iridium green. I was kind of like shrieking, basically. I was like, oh my god, can you believe what we're seeing? And you can see actually those green lines around the edges of some of the works. So for example, with the young sailor, there is a smidgen of green on the top of the painting and on the bottom of the painting in a vertical alignment. It was completely astounding. For one, it mimics the paneling that's in the studio, but also it makes the Red Studio much more like the studio in spirit, right?
Which is kind of an accurate representation. So the intermediate stage before the red came on, we think, was a blue wall with green lines for the paneling and then green molding along the bottom. The pink floor, and then the furniture was all ochre. Then he kept it and was thinking about it and didn't touch it for, like, we estimate a month, if not more. And then he went for the red in almost one shot. I think it's just very courageous. And then you can look at the UV photo and you see the brush strokes, and so that's another. Right, the brush strokes are very fast, very quick.
There is these like hairs that are stuck in the paint because it was so vigorously applying it that it would just get pulled off of the brush. And he didn't go back and take them off.
It just gave me a sense of how resolved he was.
Yeah, even after using the Venetian red to cover the foreground and the wall, he then continued on and used the red to paint over the figures in the painting in the upper right, and also in the frame of the large room on the left.
I mean, think about all those details he painted out and got rid of, and it no longer really looks like a studio, and it becomes this abstract work because of the red.
Kind of imparts a bit of serenity looking at it. It doesn't feel so loud, it doesn't feel so brash.
This radical shift in tonality and color, and this choice of red is so bold, there is no going back.
He saw this as a completed, finished work
he writes his name in very thin ochre paint.
And especially on the top of an area that was originally ochre.
Yes.